We're happy to be back at Finovate. Last time we were presented as Billshrink. Now we're Truaxis. The reason for change is because our platform, Statement Rewards, has become a rich data-driven personalized services platform, a platform that puts the power of the user's transaction history to work for them and you. We have launched six different services to date: bill analysis, purchase rewards, social influencers, geo-enabled rewards, future spend incentives, and unified loyalty, all of which you can choose from. We are now adding a seventh to the menu, which is purchase insights. There are two key innovations to the purchase insights innovation: transaction genome-based recommendations. These are recommendations that are based off of your transaction history. Just like your genetic pattern similarities predict behaviors, so do similar transaction patterns as well. We also have social benchmarking, which is effectively a platform that enables you to get visibility into your spend patterns, but also get a benchmark against others that spend like you. Two-thirds of people surveyed said that they like to see some of this stuff. In fact, 3-to-1 said they'd like to see it from their financial institutions. So let's jump in and look at what each of these things does.
Great. So to give the demonstration today of our new Purchase Insights feature, I've logged into my Wells Fargo checking account. We don't currently have a live partnership with Wells Fargo, but thanks to our single line of JavaScript integration, I'm able to show you, just using a bookmark extension, how this would work in a live online banking environment. So you can see here a number of statement rewards additions to the screen. I'm going to click here. This will open up an iframe on top of my online banking session. We're going to dive right into the recommendations. So here you're seeing a list of system-generated recommendations tailored for my specific individual account activity. So you can think of this just like Netflix will recommend you movies, Pandora will recommend you music. Truaxis will make recommendations for you for stores and restaurants at locations near you. And the way it works is, well, we can process trillions of transactions across the millions of users in our network to drive, to find key insights, correlations, things that will be specifically relevant to you. So let's look at a couple of these examples here. So here at the top, I'm seeing a recommendation for Cheeky Monkey, which is a local toy store near my hometown. Now, the reason why this recommendation is being computed is because there's a density of users who shop at Great America, Toys R Us, Chuck E. Cheese, just like I do, but in addition, they also shop at Cheeky Monkey. And so what the system does is it looks for opportunities to help me find stores that I don't currently shop at. And the fact is that though the system thinks of me as someone who has kids and tags me accordingly, it's the fact that other shoppers who are also tagged as having kids shop at Cheeky Monkey which drives this recommendation. Another quick example is Banzai Sushi. It's a sushi restaurant near where I live as well. What the system was able to glean is that there's a number of shoppers in our system, sushi eaters, who shop at Naomi's like I do, but they also visit Banzai. And not only do they visit, but they've actually shown a high repeat visit rate, which we use as a marker for loyalty, which is a really important ingredient of how our relevancy algorithm works, which is the engine that's sort of underneath the hoods that's figuring out what are the right set of recommendations I should give any user. We actually provide an abstracted view of that relevancy directly into the user interface, so the user can understand the confidence of each of the various recommendations that's presented here. The system continues to learn with every user interaction, both implicit and explicit feedback the user can provide, such as liking or disliking a recommendation. The system will continue to get fine-tuned to my preferences. If a reward is available for a specific recommendation, that'll also be presented here directly within the screen as well. I'm going to click here to see a few more recommendations. You'll notice that there's a mix of national and local recommendations. There are a wide variety of categories. But the density of recommendations will come in the categories like restaurants and personal services, area where consumers have shown an affinity towards receiving recommendations. In fact, two-thirds of the shoppers we spoke with would like to see Netflix-style recommendations within their online banking environments. And we believe we can help FIs satisfy that growing demand. So I'm going to click on Spend Summary to give you a little bit more visibility. So as you can probably guess, there's a lot of data and metadata that's flowing through our system. And one of the goals of Purchase Insights is to surface that information directly for our customers. Here you're seeing a view of my top merchants where I've spent at. There's a bunch of controls here at the top where I can slice and dice the data by different time frames. I can look by how much I'm spending versus my number of visits. And I can also view my top merchants, my top categories, or even locations. I'll click here on locations, and here you'll see the transaction stream will be analyzed to see what the distribution of my transactions are by city, by distance from my home location, and even by breakdown of online versus offline spend here at the bottom. So, you know, all this is available to the user with no additional setup or integration. It's sort of just for free with statement rewards, which is important because 84% of users have said that they want to get this type of information directly from their online banking provider without any additional integration. A third aspect of our application is what we call social benchmarking, which basically allows a user to take these spend summaries and put it into context by comparing against various reference groups. So here, the gray bars that you're seeing here are showing how my spend at these top five merchants compare to the U.S. national average. There's a number of other geo-based averages here as well, state, city. I'm going to click on people similar to me. The key here is that I'm going to get my spend compared to people who are similar to me. I mean, they've been tagged with attributes similar to mine around the dimensions of age, gender, household type, et cetera. Now, the system will automatically deduce those based on the transaction stream, but the user can always come and refine those designations as appropriate. The last reference group I want to talk about is private groups. And this is actually the ability for a user to define a custom set of people who they want to compare their data with, friends or family members. Here I'm comparing to a group of friends in a group I created previously. The administration of these groups happens directly within the platform, so you can see down here at the bottom, I could create a new group. Once I've created a group, I can use the integrated social media features to broadcast this out. So anyone with the statement rewards enabled account can use this to get the same benefit. And it's all, no personal information is used in the system at all. The platform is, if you can switch to the mobile device, for those of you who remember from Fall Finovate, we also have a mobile application. We've enhanced it to include the recommendations feature. So here you can see the system will generate a list of recommendations that are relevant to my exact location where I am right now. If I click on one of these, I can get some additional information, including some background of the recommendation and some context for the relevancy of this particular recommendation.
And all of this functionality is powered by algorithms that are already running on our online platform to power all of the other services on the platform. We're merely surfacing more of that data to users in ways that they value as well as which drives benefits to FIs. Two-thirds of people surveyed actually want to see this kind of functionality. In fact, Javelin reported that 3-to-1, they want to see it from their FIs. Statement Rewards platform puts the power of user transaction history to work for you and your customers with a single line of HTML on your websites. Come talk to us at our booth on how we can help you get the same.